What does a construction estimator do? Well, if that's been your question because you found out how much a construction estimator can make, then I know exactly what you need to know. In this episode, we're going to talk about what a construction estimator does and why it is such a great profession in the construction industry. So not only are we going to tell you what does a construction estimator do, but I'm just also going to give you a little bit of insight about how to get your foot in the door. So you may think that you don't have a lot of construction experience, and so that disqualifies you from being a construction estimator. Well, we all had to start somewhere. So if you've ever wondered about what it's going to take to be a construction manager and what experience you're going to need to make that happen, follow along and we'll get to it through this episode. So, do you think estimating is just all about math? Well, it's a lot more than that. And as I've said before, is that construction estimating and scheduling really go hand in hand. So not only understanding estimating is going to be important for your role as a construction estimator, but also understanding schedule and how you apply that to your construction estimates. Now, a construction estimator does a lot more than just bidding projects. Their experience and the way that they're able to create and build estimates by their knowledge of understanding how to do calculations for labor, material, and equipment are all going to be used throughout the entire project in determining change orders, in determining the proposed work or scope that an owner might want to do. It's going to be determining the budget of the project, even identifying the feasibility of the project and whether or not we even have enough money to go forward. So the role of an estimator in determining a construction project is essential. This is an amazing opportunity for anybody wanting to enter the construction industry. Now, you don't have to have construction experience to be a construction manager, but the more construction experience you have, the better you will be. Okay, so it is very important to know and understand the order of precedence, how things are built and what order they're built in, understanding the cost for things, which means being a good researcher and identifying how much is Home Depot selling things for and where can I get that lumber cheaper in another location, for being able to have relationships and building the types of relationships necessary with subcontractors, suppliers, manufacturers in getting the very best bid for what you're trying to estimate. And so an estimator is going to be kind of all things. And so in that realization of your job as an estimator, it's a much bigger task than just playing with numbers. As an estimator, there's going to be certain skill sets that you're going to have in play. Being very analytical or understanding how to solve problems is going to be important. Being very detailed and very precise in your calculations and your numbers. Being very organized and managed. A lot of times I like to use colored pencils and be able to color all of the times that I've identified the doors or the windows so I don't accidentally have to go back and count all of that all over again. So those are going to be important things that you're going to look at, but other skills that you need to have in place are just a little bit of common sense and understanding of how a construction project runs, not just what happens out on the job site, but the flow of the work from the administrative side all the way through the actual construction taking place out on the job site. This is all intertwined in it, and that's why your experience and flexibility of understanding costs and what attributes to cost and what will have impacts on the construction schedule and the construction project are all going to be very important in your role as a construction estimator. A lot of times, being a negotiator is going to be part of the responsibilities of a construction estimator. I mean, you generated the estimate, who better to defend it? So it may be asked upon you to negotiate some of these terms that are being provided by a construction manager or a contractor, for you to be able to explain why it needs to be that dollar amount, and here's the reasons why, and providing evidence in order to be able to support it. We can't just say that's how much it costs because I said so. So as much as we want to be able to just identify a cost for something and then roll on to the next role or responsibility that we have to do, it's very important for us to be able to describe, explain, and provide evidence to support why we believe that that cost is what it should be. And this will become evident when you're negotiating across the table, when someone else is trying to explain their purpose for the cost, and you're able to deflect that by identifying that, well, actually, certified payroll shows that there was an apprentice working in that position, so your change order shows a journeyman. We need to reduce the cost of the hourly rate and not be going with the journeyman wage, but rather having the apprentice that was working on that change order in the first place. So being able to use situations like that will be very important. And a lot of that is going to start depending on your construction experience and your ability to be able to lean on experience from others who've already been where you're going. So working with your mentors and understanding from skilled estimators and negotiators the different tactics that they take in their estimator role is going to help you become a better estimator. We could also go into what is the day-to-day of an estimator. Are they always working on some 4-inch thick drawings of some Las Vegas casino? No, that's not how it works every single day. So we want to make sure that we have an organized, managed day in our estimating process. So knowing and understanding that bids do take a lot of time and they have defined deadlines. And so during that, you're going to have to know and understand your time blocks and how you're able to manage and negotiate that time for yourself in being able to build those bids. But while those bids are happening, there's work on other projects where people need to be able to get estimates from you so that they can order material that has a long procurement, so that they can understand what skilled labor is going to need to be called to the job site next week. So there's a lot of other day-to-day responsibilities that a construction estimator is going to be working on. A lot of that is going to include that research of determining what current costs are, what's happening out in the world today that is going to be impacting my estimate that I submit tomorrow. So this is a really big thing that has come up here recently. We're dealing with the shortage of supplies, and the time delay in the delivery of some of our supplies has really impacted our cost on projects. And so as an estimator, kind of having a little bit of intuition of knowing what's going to happen in that crystal ball here in the next 2 to 3 months is going to be really important in you being able to create accurate, thorough, and comprehensive estimates. So if we talk about becoming an estimator, we have to talk about the different softwares that you're going to be using. Now, here's where the rub is. A lot of our individuals out on the job site who've been doing hands-on construction work, they have the most complete and amazing background construction knowledge, that to use that knowledge and apply it into an estimate is going to keep your estimates tight. It's going to allow you to have more profit. It's going to allow you to have more detail in developing your estimate. But the problem is a lot of these individuals didn't get into construction management because they don't really like computers. They don't really like having to change software. Now, I'm no stranger to being afraid of updates. I literally won't plug my phone into the Wi-Fi so I don't have to deal with trying to find my contacts the next day. But this is part of what we have when we're working with softwares. Those of us that have been in the industry for a long time, we don't like updates. Once we've learned something, we want to know and have confidence that we can keep working in that area that we've learned. But this is where our younger generation coming in has been very adaptable in being able to be flexible and move quickly with these updates. So whether you're a new construction manager stepping into the industry with very little construction knowledge, or you're someone with a lot of construction knowledge stepping into having to understand computers and software, this is a challenge for both ends of the spectrum. So you're going to be able to do it. It's just a matter of where you're focusing your knowledge and your education in order to be able to lift up that area that you're a little bit weaker in. And these softwares really are not that tough. They're pretty common sense softwares that we use. And if you know the order of precedence and you know how you want to perform the work, then we're able to use that information in these softwares that at a base level are pretty similar. They all work pretty similarly, and then they have their features that then take them out and make them a little bit different. So when we're looking at softwares, looking at things like Bluebeam or looking at P6 or any of the other softwares that we want to use in your estimating career, it's going to be specific to wherever you go to work. They're going to be using a certain software that they've become comfortable with and that they love, and so that's the software that you're going to be learning. So where do we start? Then I would say that someone that has a tremendous amount of construction experience is going to be able to start an estimate by developing it first off of the computer and off of software and designing it on paper. Now, this would be the exact same place that I want my early construction manager to also start. Because if you can't do it by scratch, then when you put it into the software, you're not going to know where the challenges are or where the corrections need to be made. And so it is important that you know how to do this from fundamental basics. As somebody that has a lot of experience, your next step would then be going to a class or learning more about the software, shadowing with someone at the company who's allowing you to work on smaller projects for you to be able to put an estimate together. For my early entry construction manager, you're probably going to be more adapted to that software technology. And so knowing and understanding the structure of the process of construction is going to be critical. You're going to be able to do by hand calculations, know and understand how many hours a day labor is going to be working on something. But knowing and understanding the order that makes the work more efficient or more productive is going to be important when you're determining your production in a workday. So when we're starting, we want to get our foot in the door. We want to be able to rely and lean on a mentor, someone who's experienced at construction, who can talk to us about the process of construction, and who can walk us through how to be able to use some of those software technology tools. So have you ever thought of becoming an estimator and breaking into an estimate career? Maybe you're already working and going to school is not an option. Then I want you to go to our Skill Builder on the Construction Management Online. Skill Builder is going to be construction management task-specific training that's going to walk you step-by-step of everything that you need to know about construction estimating. So if becoming a construction estimator is where you want to be, then I'm excited to be able to join you on this journey.